Hey guys, Civil Lord here, back again with another review, and today we'll be taking a look at the McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse Walmart exclusive Rebirth Shazam. Now before we get into the meat and taters of this review, kindly moving Mr. Barry Batson out of the way for just a moment so we can take a quick look at both the front and the back of the packaging. And just a quick side note about window boxes, or quick sec here. I much prefer the window box packaging over the windowless packaging that Hasbro's doing. But one thing I'm not crazy about is the little plastic ties that the Todd Father uses to hold his figures in the window box packaging. They're kind of a pain in the nougats, and they could probably afford to cut them out. Might even save them a penny or two. So with that being said, like every other package, so long, see you later, you're out of here. So we have plastic to talk about. We don't talk about cardboard here, we talk about plastic. The wonderful, magnificent plastic that is this DC Multiverse Shazam. That said, we do have to talk about cardboard for just a second because he does come with a collectible trading card. Didn't think I was going to forget this, did ya? You should know better. That said, it does feature artwork from the source material, I believe, on the front there, which is nice. I do prefer that. Watch, it's a picture this time. That said, there is a bio on the back that you can pause and read at your own leisure, but long story short, Billy Batson is not actually a grown arse man. He is actually just a little kid, and he gets the powers of Shazam, which is actually I don't believe it's an alliteration, but it's a combination of the first letter of all the Greek gods, spells Shazam, although some of them are actually the Roman names of the Greek gods, but you get the idea. He gets his powers from, I believe, Shazam himself. And then he is able to turn into Shazam by saying Shazam. It's pretty simple, pretty straightforward, and actually not an original DC character. I believe Shazam or Captain Marvel, not to be confused with the Marvel Universe Captain Marvel, who is a total B-I-T-C-H in the MCU, he was an independent Leon character. So take that for what you will. DC Comics bought him out, and now he's part of the DC Universe. Pretty cool stuff there. That said, there is a debacle between calling him Shazam and Captain Marvel, at least I've noticed on the internet over the past several years. Some people are elitist and call him Captain Marvel. I prefer Shazam, most because it's shorter. So, quick little Shazam trivia for you there, because I've never covered a traditional looking Shazam on this channel. I've covered that piece of crap King Shazam, infected King Shazam, who's cool when you get one that's not a piece of junk, but I had two that were total pieces of junk. Took one on clearance from Dorkside Toys, cost $6 to get one that didn't suck quite as bad. But we're not gonna rant about that figure. I already did that a year ago. Check that review out if you haven't already. That said, Shazam also comes with a pair of open hands, which are kind of large. I think these and the fists he comes with are a little bit on the large side, but it's better than nothing, I guess. It's better than just having pegs. Could have no hands, you know. That's a thing. And he also comes with these two little lightning effects, which we did see with the Black Adam Endless Winter figure. And side note, speaking of which, this figure is essentially the Black Adam Endless Winter figure with a different neck setup because he's got the cape and a different lightning bolt on his chest. Other than that, I think everything else other than the head is the same as that Black Adam Endless Winter figure. So if you want to know a little bit more about that, check out that review, which I posted a long arse freaking time ago in the town of Kickapoo. I'm lying, of course. I don't live in Kickapoo. I live in upstate New York. I'm not telling you where I live. That said, it does come with the trademark hockey puck display stand that we're used to seeing with all McFarlane Toys releases. And here is Shazam. Really nice figure. of a character that is not in, like, my top 10 DC characters, but I do like Shazam. I really like the Shazam movie. Looking forward to Fury of the Gods, so maybe this review will get a little bit of hype traffic, if you know what I mean. That said, Mr. Brian, a.k.a. my dad, a.k.a. the old man, actually had to go out of town for this one. He was already out of town, but he found it about 30 minutes from where I'm currently located, because my Walmart only got the Parallax and the Dark Flash. Not once have we seen this guy around here, and we also, of course, haven't seen the frickin' Nightfall Batman, which I still do not have. I don't think Santa Claus is going to be able to hook that up. I think it's just out of our control at this point. Really kind of sucks, but whatever. I got Shazam, I got the Dark Flash, I got Parallax, I got some of the Target exclusives. I'm not doing too bad as far as finding stuff goes, but the one I really want I don't have, so I guess there's a double-edged sword there. That said, as far as articulation on this figure is concerned, he can look side to side. Can look up a little bit. I think his up and down kind of sucks. Not gonna lie, we've seen better double ball pegs in this line, and this one's pretty limited. Do get a little bit of tilt, but not a lot. His shoulders can go out, back down, forward and back. They are in that ball socket, but you don't get a lot of play in there. He's got a bicep swivel, double jointed elbow, which does work okay. Looks kind of chunky, not gonna lie, but it's fine. Also has a hinge ball peg in the wrist here, a hinge swivel wrist. So it rotates in the arm, in the hand itself, and has a hinge in the middle. Works fine. I will say, you're going to want to be careful swapping on these extra hands, because they are a bit tricky to pull the fists off. The extra hands are actually really easy to put on, but these, not so much. That said, he does have a ball joint in the torso that does get a little bit of forward, a little bit of back, actually quite a bit of back, even though he does have this big heavy cape, which it would be nice if this was soft goods, just be less weight on the back of the figure. He does have some rotation up here. It works fine. I think this is a double ball peg. It feels like one. There's a little bit of a gap on the back, but you don't really notice it because of the cape. He does have a tilt side to side. That does work pretty well. The waist, of course, works. It's okay. It's not perfect, but it's not terrible. Again, I think, if anything, the gap on the back makes things a little loose. So they could afford to sculpt a little bit more, cover that up. It'd just look a little cleaner, even though you can't really see it. But it'd at least make things a little tighter. That said, can kind of adjust him accordingly, so that gap is a little bit more covered, but it's not perfect. Said he can kick forward, he can kick back a little bit. He actually has quite a bit of cake going on. Can kick out to the side pretty far. Back down. He's got a little bit of play in the thigh, but not a ton. It's really tight too, so you're gonna want to be careful with that. He does have a double knee. It does work. It is kind of a pain in the nougats to get to the bottom one to bend. There you go. There. Kind of chunky, again. Very big cuts in there. And then his feet are also on the ball hinge joints. So they do rotate. And they do hinge. And they have the rocker and the toe joint, which is actually tight and neutral on both sides. But yeah, unlike the John Constantine I looked at yesterday, he's got the peg holes in the bottom of the feet as well. But unlike the John Constantine I took a look at yesterday, his hands aren't very easy to pop off. You're going to want to be very careful, because this side, I popped the ball peg in half, and now it doesn't have the little detents in it, which kind of sucks. Although it didn't really have much to begin with, but it was, I think it was better than this. I can't even remember how it was. It didn't last very long. Either way, it is what it is. It's tight. It's not loose, but it is annoying. Very much so. So, with that being said, I do still really like this figure. despite that one little issue I had with mine, I'm sure that's not going to be with all of them. You just want to be careful popping the hands off, because they can be a bit of a bitch to get back on there if you pop that joint in half, which I think they need to do away with that joint. I'm not a fan of that. I'm not a fan of the toe joints. I'm not a fan of the ball hinge wrists. The ball hinge feet are okay. That's kind of what you want. And I'm not crazy about the butterfly things. I think they're getting a little loose lately and could use some tidying up. But, excuse me. Other than that, I don't really have any issues with this figure. I think it's a fine figure. The mold is okay. It's got some gnarly cuts in it, but it's nothing terrible. It's fine. It's serviceable. If you want a traditional-looking Shazam, you don't really have a choice. You only have this one. I do really like this figure, and I think this is a perfect tried-and-true traditional-looking Shazam, even though it's a more modern take on that. I think it'll look great with the Black Adam Endless Winter figure, even though that's Endless Winter, technically, and not a Rebirth one. Or I guess if you have the Page Puncher, too, that would work as well. But that said, unlike Constantine, I actually do have some comparisons. So before this review drags on any longer than it already has, let's now move on and take a look at some size comparisons. First up, here's our new-ish Rebirth Shazam, alongside a couple other figures that utilize the same buck as he does, the Infected King Shazam and the Endless Winter Black Adam, who of course came with a piece to build the infamous Frost King, which is still a really solid collect-to-build figure in this line, might I add. Very festive for this time of year too, since it's cold as balls in upstate New York. That said, as you can see, these three are essentially the same height, which I think is fine. Maybe Black Adam could benefit from being a little taller, but I do not have that Page Puncher's one as of right now, so I don't know if that one is maybe a little bit taller or utilizes different parts to make him taller, but I do prefer my villains taller than the heroes. But if any hero is going to be an equal to his arch nemesis, I think Shazam is a good candidate for that, since he is kind of like a Superman character. It's a little bit bigger than your average superhero, so I think that totally works. That said, as far as this Infected Shazam goes, it's an acquired taste. I think it looks cool, but I know some people think the Death Metal, Dark Knight's Metal, Speed Metal, whatever metal. Is there a Black Metal comic? I'd love to know stuff. Either way, looks kind of silly and stupid, but I like it. It is what it is. And last, but certainly not least, we have our two regulars, the Mythic Legion's Brother Mandibulus, beloved Spawn, who's not towering over good old Billy Batson, but is slightly taller, just by a little teeny weeny bit. That said, what would happen if Spawn said Shazam? All hell would break loose, I assume. So with that being said, time to wrap things up with some final thoughts. Overall, and aside from the typical McFarlane Toys loose joint issues and issues I had with this base body prior to picking up this figure, I do still really like this figure. Billy Batson, aka Shazam, I think is a fine addition to the McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse line, despite any qualms I have with this base body, which are mostly due in part to my experience with the Infected King Shazam, which for lack of a better term was excellent sandwich. That said, of the characters that utilize this base body, I still believe that the Endless Winter Collect-A-Build Frost King Wave Black Adam did it best, which is kind of ironic considering the second release of this base body had the tightest joints as opposed to the first, but I suppose that is what it is, I guess. That said, when a Hasbro does that, it seems to me like their bodies just get more and more lame and sucky and crappy and junky over time, while McFarlane tends to make little tweaks here and there to try and make things better, which is, last I checked anyways, what you're supposed to do. That said, if you are looking for a more traditional looking Shazam for your DC Multiverse collection, then at this current time anyways, you really don't have a choice. And hopefully you were able to find this guy at Walmart, because I know he's been out for a while now, and he was a little tricky to find because, again, Walmart, but in case you missed out on him, don't fret, because I do believe we'll see more Shazam figures for Fury of the Gods, both movie and comic book alike. That said, I'm really looking forward to that movie because the first Shazam movie I thought was really fun. One of my favorite DC movies of all time. Right up there with the first Wonder Woman, the first Aquaman, and Batman 89. That said, hopefully we don't get any more movies like Wonder Woman 84 because that movie, much like the Infected King Shazam was, for lack of a better term, a turd sandwich. So with that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this review. If you're so inclined, please don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you know whenever I upload more reviews like this one. If you haven't already, please hit me up on Instagram at Overlord Productions. But as always, keep the comment civil, because the world sucks enough as it is, especially when you try to pop off your hand and you pop your wrist joint in two. That's just a bad day, man. May want to see a doctor about that. Until next time, I'll catch you guys later.